bring me anything. Pakistani government didn't give me shit.
Quite a spiritual experience, you guys.
Wow, that's a different world.
Pauses.
This is all about rich people on the left side. It's all about slums.
This is the ISA headquarters.
Yeah.
Very tight lock on almost every factor of the society.
The Christians are the underclass.
Yeah, I guess.
Good morning, guys. I'm not gonna lie, I'm a bit sick right now, but I'm gonna pull my shit together and we're gonna get out into Islamabad. Got some guys we're gonna meet up with, some cool locals. Met them last night, very interesting guys that are gonna get us into the guts of this city. Yeah, get a shower, some breakfast. I'll be better and we'll do this. Okay, here with Amar, and Umar. Where are we off to, guys?
We are basically going to Faisal Mosque.
This is the iconic mosque of Islamabad, right?
Yeah, and it's basically the largest mosque in Pakistan.
Here we are coming up to a massive square. This was built by the Saudis.
Yeah.
When was it built?
Back in the
1970s. 70s, okay. Wow. Guys, what's the reason for washing before a prayer?
Yeah, it's just like the purification of our body.
So the guys went to pray and I sat at the back of the mosque observing. Firstly, the architecture here is absolutely stunning and uplifting. I admire many things about Islam. There is a very strong feeling of unity, that everyone is connected through something much greater than themselves. There is purpose in the regularity of prayer and hospitality. Most Muslims I've met in the world have always been very open and welcoming.
Quite a spiritual experience, you guys.
Yeah.
Even for me, and I don't know what's going on. It's very calm and peaceful in there. It's a new city and it has a grid pattern. And if you compare it to other cities in Pakistan, it's very orderly and modern.
Yeah.
Wide laned roads. And there's regions, right? You call it like F something, and what is it called? Like where I'm
F6, staying? F7.
F6, F7.
Yeah, these sectors.
Sectors, yes. Assalamu alaikum. You guys, I'm taking a video. Is that cool?
Where are you traveling from?
I'm from the US.
Okay.
Yeah.
Welcome to Pakistan.
Thank you.
First trip?
First time.
Okay.
I love it.
Good.
It's very interesting.
I'm so glad that you can see it for yourself instead of just in the news.
Yes, exactly. And that's why I'm making these videos. Okay. So I show other people this experience.
Okay.
How are you, man?
Good, brother.
I'm sorry I'm just late.
So Wakar's late.
Yeah.
It's okay. We met last night.
Yeah.
And you're the wealth of knowledge.
Yeah, thank you very much,
on
man.
On Islamabad. Yeah, a lot of security here, I've seen.
Yep. This is the red zone.
Actually, it's called red zone, that's why.
So this is where the diplomats...
Yeah, you can say that. Is this Punjabi music? Guru Randhawa with Pitbull.
Pitbull?
Yeah. In the 60s, Islamabad was announced as the capital of Pakistan.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's mostly government workers
here. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So what about you guys? Do you like living here in the city?
Yeah, exactly. This is the capital of the country, and obviously it is very, we really enjoy to live here.
But you don't want to be in like the big buzzing Karachi or Lahore?
Yeah, Karachi is also very great and Lahore is also very cool. But you know, the environmental issues of the cities like smog and all that.
Yeah,
traffic issues and your security.
Actually, infrastructure of Islamabad is very good.
Very good.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
this is peaceful. This is very enjoyable. Amara, when did you guys stop using plastic bags?
About 3 months ago, I guess plastic bags are banned now.
Look at that chocolate selection. That's solid. I'd say one of the easier things. Oh, shit.
Whatever.
Bag. No plastic bags, you know that?
Yeah.
So now they got these, but they don't work so well.
They just implemented that almost a month ago.
3 months ago.
Yeah, almost 3 months.
Amar just told me.
Yeah.
Okay. Shukriya. I gotta say, it's for all of us, chocolate. Okay. So one of the cool things about traveling Pakistan is the language barrier. In the cities, most people speak English. It's easy to get by in English. Everything's written in English. And okay, it's always cool to speak the other language, but let's be real.
It has been a British colony.
Yes, of course. But let's be real. Like, you're not going to learn Urdu in a week.
Yeah.
So it makes it super easy to navigate and travel.
Yeah.
What's this building? That's cool.
That's just, disputed hotel. You can say that. A disputed hotel.
Disputed hotel.
Yeah.
Means
because from the top of the hotel, you can see almost all of the red zone. So that's why, due to the security threat, they just,
gotcha.
Yeah, stop the construction and all that.
So you were telling me, Amar, the U.S. Embassy here, the workers make 3 times as much money as than other embassies?
Because of their lives, they are not secure as compared with the other developed countries.
Okay.
So, that's why.
Is my life secure here?
Yeah, you can see.
With you guys?
Yeah.
It's all about who you're with?
Yeah, exactly. We are in sector F63, Islamabad, the most VVIP and elite sector of Islamabad. And
the wealthiest neighborhood of the city. Now, are elite people, when you say elite people, does that mean government people?
Elite people mean the rich people.
Okay, but are the rich people here mostly in government?
Yeah, you can say that.
Lot of barbed wire and guns.
Yeah.
You know, I've seen a lot of guns here. A lot of guys with security.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of businesses with security, a lot of homes. They're bored as hell too. They're never doing anything, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Assalamu alaikum. This looks to be a nice restaurant. You guys making a movie?
Yeah, drama.
Making a drama. Day 69.
Day 69.
Wow, that's a drama in itself. Yeah. That's a lot of work.
Improvise kar lena.
I don't know. Improvise kar.
Improvise. The famous words of a director. So this is one of the nicer zones in the city, right? This area?
Yes, it's
where are you gonna take us? You said the slums. There's some slums.
Yeah, exactly. Let's go to the
Have
slums.
We seen all the rich neighborhood?
Yeah, I think we have seen that.
We've seen some of the rich, okay. Yeah. Let's go to the slums. I wanna see the contrast.
Okay.
I think it's hard for the Western viewer to understand. At least it's been a surprise.
Yeah.
It's been a surprise for me to see that environment, right?
Yeah.
In Bin Laden was 2 hours from here.
Yeah.
Right?
But that was time when the wave of the terrorism, that was a very rough one.
Right.
But now, Pakistan is all about the peace, stability, and there is no such thing as terrorism because the army stood up against such actual terrorists. And now, I think that they have eliminated almost 99% of all of the terrorist group. Yeah, you can say that this is the most VVIP sector, and just in the middle of this sector is the people lives like shitty life.
In the middle of that.
In the middle of that.
Huh.
Those people are basically servants, you can say that, okay?
Gotcha.
And they work in the houses of like VIP people.
They're all Christian?
That. Yeah, they're all Christians. No Muslims live there. And the colonies, so in the colonies of the, that, that slums.
The Christians are the underclass here.
Yeah, exactly.
What's the history to that, do you know?
They have supported the British colonies.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow, that's a different world.
Yeah.
Than what we just saw. And the rich stuff is right behind it, right?
Yeah, exactly. I think that when these people apply for visa for America or some other country,
yeah,
they have a very successful ratio rather than compared to us.
Really?
Exactly.
Because they're Christians.
Yeah, because they're Christians. Of the Islamophobia effect.
Right.
We are not allowed.
So you're an educated guy, you have a university degree, and it's harder for you to get a visa than these guys.
These people,
Salam. They have a cool billiards table. Salam alaikum.
All of them have jobs. All of them.
They all have jobs.
Yeah, all of them have jobs.
Like on the low level, like the sweeper.
Just please capture this. Yeah, people there are playing cards.
You know, in a lot of the slums I've been in, quite often there's like a tight community
But trust
feel to them.
This house, this is all about rich people on this side of the sector.
Yeah.
But on the left side, it's all about slums then.
Guys, do you think there's much else up here or not really?
Yeah, but there is. When you go deep inside, it's just like the walled city of Lahore.
The church over there. Full gospel?
Yeah.
Assembly Church Islamabad. Yeah. Is that the only Christian church in the city?
No, not in the city. There is also a very VIP church.
Salam alaikum. Well, I don't say that here, right? Because it's Christian.
No, they understand. They understand that, yeah.
Okay.
Salam.
Okay. Never say never. Nice. Repair situation. So I give the Islamic greeting even though they're Christian.
No, the meaning of the Islamic greeting is that may Allah bless you. May Allah bless you. May God bless you. Okay?
Do you guys want some popcorn?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Yeah, there's not popcorn.
Okay. The Australian government's here too. Holy of Holies Church. Hello.
It's okay?
You see the Christmas decorations everywhere. Santa Clauses.
25th December is very near. You can
interesting. So can you tell if somebody is Christian just by looking at them? How?
Like 99% of the cases, we can look at their color and the way they talk. The way they talk, that is a little bit different than the others. But we being a Muslim, we are totally comfortable with them. You know?
Okay, so these
there is no such thing as like
these ladies are all Christian, right?
Yeah, almost.
How do you know if someone's Christian by the way they talk?
In the accent of their, the way they talk, the way they, the way they talk, the way they speak, and the way they, like, you know, there is a little bit.
Okay.
A little bit difference.
So you can tell I'm not Muslim.
We can only say that you are an American. Once he tried for the shoot here, and you know, the agents of the ISA, they picked them and they bring them inside and they said, why were you taking pictures?
This is the ISA headquarters.
Yeah. So
Pakistani intelligence,
which
are very good.
Best of the world. At least intelligence.
They know everything.
Yeah.
Do you feel like they have a tight lock on society? They know everyone's business?
They have a very tight lock. They have a very tight lock on almost every factor of the society.
So guys, what is this? What are we going into here?
Yeah, that's
it's called that Pakistan Monument.
Pakistan Monument.
What would you say is the coolest thing about Pakistan? What gets you excited about Pakistan these days?
Like in the past, there were some issues, like, you know, there were not very much stability in Pakistan, but right now I must say that all of the world should come to Pakistan for the tourism purpose. The government has taken great initiatives to promote tourism. Like, you know that you came on the Italian passport, like, directly by e-visa, by applying in the e-visa.
Full disclosure, guys, nobody's paying me anything. Pakistani government didn't give me I don't want it, because I don't want to be controlled with my content.
At least you're not facing any issue.
That is no issues. No, yeah. No. I'm an American here on an Italian passport. Yeah. That's beautiful. What is this?
This is the monument, Pakistan Monument.
Is of independence?
No. Memory of, you know, Pakistan and all that.
I wanna say that you are so beautiful. And like Johnny Sins, you look like
Johnny Sins.
Like
Johnny Sins.
And so we are so terrified, and we change our route from that place to there.
You're scared of Johnny Sins?
Like Johnny.
He's ideal.
You like Johnny?
I'm not like Johnny.
No, do you like Johnny?
Oh, I like Johnny.
Yeah.
Yeah, I am his follower.
I've been trying to keep this out of the video, but I'm just gonna let it go. I every single place I go, they say this.
Nice.
It's not the first time I was called Johnny Sins. Nice to meet you. Thank you, guys. Johnny. All right, guys. That's it, Islamabad, quiet place, spacious place, calm place, especially compared to Lahore. Cool guys, that was really interesting, learning through them. And I'm off to the mountains. Excuse me. About an hour flight up into some of the most beautiful peaks in the world. And we'll continue there. Good night. Like and subscribe if you want to support this channel. Hit the notification bell to be the first to see my next video. Many more videos about Pakistan and other parts of the world coming soon.